Many Americans seem to just accept the nation's 50% divorce rate. However, there are proven methods to make marriages last, and whole communities can take advantage.
Like most places, the divorce rate in Kansas City, Missouri has been going up. But right across the state line here in Kansas City, Kansas, it's been going down. What's made the difference?
In 1996, suburban pastor Jeff Myers teamed up with urban pastor Leroy Sullivan to fight for marriage.
If it fails, it's the pebble in the pond, the waves that reverberate out go on for generations. Then I thought, where's the church? This is our issue. This is the thing we should be dealing with.
And we're so busy talking about let's go to heaven, we never teach people how to live on earth.
Myers and Sullivan spent months recruiting dozens of other pastors in the Kansas City, Kansas area to sign a community marriage policy, a pledge to fight hard to make marriages last. And over the next 10 years, the town saw an amazing 70% plunge in the divorce rate, from 650 in 1995 to just 196 in 2005. One method focused on recruiting and training couples with long-lasting marriages to become mentors, working especially with those about to marry. The DeFreeses have mentored for 14 years.
You're using your years of experience coupled with some training and listening skills and communication skills.
The Llewellyns have mentored a dozen young couples.
How well do you know each other? And are you really meant to be together? Just because you love each other, it doesn't mean you're called to be life-term partners.
These marriage coaches help couples who want to wed take a premarital inventory, which can predict with 80% accuracy which couples will likely divorce.
We've had, I know, two decide not to marry.
And mentors help young couples seriously consider areas of potential trouble.
The preparation process lots of times brings out areas that maybe they've never discussed before or thought about.
Well, you have the communication tools to give and take and find, you know, how you're going to work together.
Pastors in more than 220 communities have now signed community marriage policies, offering pre-marriage exams and mentoring couples. Mike McManus of Marriage Savers has championed these concepts for decades. Now he's pushing more ideas in how to cut America's divorce rate in half. The U.S. rate is triple that of France and Britain, and McManus thinks one big reason is because of the waiting periods for a divorce in those nations.
You have to wait 5 years in one country and 6 years in the other to get the divorce. You know what happens in 5 years? A lot of reconciliation.
Myers says research shows if those in a failing marriage would simply wait it out for 5 years, they'd likely see a big turnaround.
66% of those couples will report a stronger, happier, wholesome marriage if they will just do that much.
McManus would like states to legislate a 2-year waiting period and get rid of no-fault divorce for couples with minor children, unless there's abuse or adultery.
What is called no-fault divorce means unilateral divorce.
He wants states to replace it with mutual consent divorce so both spouses have a say.
Here are two reforms, either one of which, in many states, could cut the divorce rate in half.
It also save a huge amount of taxpayer dollars. Taxpayers cough up $112 billion a year to pay the huge costs of families fragmenting.
They're eligible for Medicaid and food stamps and earned income tax credit and subsidies for housing and daycare and all that. That's what costs so much.
Only 1% of married women are poor, but 24% of divorced women are.
It's a devastating thing, divorces within our communities, families, and the lives of our children personally to societally.
Which is why saving marriages could do so much for a society.
I really believe in what we're doing is making eternal benefits to couples down the road.
Marriage is really the best solution for all the problems we have in our society today.
Sullivan's only had a couple of divorces in his church since his fellow pastors banded together in 1996. And as for Myers Church,
I have roughly 100 weddings that I've performed since then. I've had no divorces.
If we have a culture promoting marriage and our churches begin to capture the vision that they can be marriage savers, I think we could drive down this divorce rate nationally in half.
So as folks are showing here in Kansas City, Kansas, we don't have to accept a 50% divorce rate. And marriage for almost everyone can truly be the lifelong institution it was always meant to be. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Kansas City, Kansas.